105mm focal length is popular with portrait photographers. Mong Kok is a place where the trends move so quick that when the people wear those clothes, they were never trendy in the first place. But it can't be denied that there's a whole culture happening right here, so we've come to document it. Now this is the 105mm f2 DC. DC for defocus control. Now you don't hear that often in the camera lens world, but that's probably because Nikon has patented it. So what happens when you can control the defocus?
It features a twiddly little ring with aperture numbers on it from f2 to f5.6. This is your control for ultimate defocus pleasure.
But that doesn't mean it's a focus ring. What it actually does is that it controls the blur in your photos.
They should have at least patented the right name.
So it's really quite simple. You can either blur the bits in front of your subject or behind. F for front, R for the rear. Now when you set your aperture, you have to select it at the appropriate one here. If you select, say, f5.6 and you're shooting at f2, everything's soft in focus.
It basically controls an element at the front, so it does the exact opposite of correcting aberrations, so what you get is more blur.
Okay, let's go find some street fashion. What if they're wearing some street fashion, or are they just policemen? What if that's the whole YMCA look? Young men. See, because Alambi is the new member of our team, we're getting her to find the street fashion people, while me and Locke stay reasonably far away. Okay, Lambi, let's go. Let's go find some weirdos. I mean, fashion.
Weirdos?
Fashion. They're all dressed rather boring today.
Despite not finding any people at first, it didn't take long before we found our first target.
All right, I'll just stand here. Oh my god, what's going on there? He loves it. Okay, that's great.
And then eagle-eyed Lambi clapped her eyes on a couple of fashion gurus.
Okay. The differences really are quite subtle in terms of blurring the background.
If you're trying to see the difference through the viewfinder, you'll be looking all bloody night because you can't see any difference. The focus is a bit slow on this lens, so don't expect to chase any rabbit ladies.
The key to doing good Mong Kok fashion is to not even bother thinking about whether you should go for style A or style B. Just go for everything, put it all together. Yeah, you try that.
Finding some fashion junkies in trendy land is really quite easy. About as easy as a former Hollywood star having an affair with his housemaid. With the ring directed towards F, it makes the foreground bokeh a bit nicer. But how often do we want that? Oh no, I blurred the Digital Rev logo. And especially when it makes the background bokeh awful. Then we bumped into a fan who I thought was participating in a bit of cosplay, but it turned out he was actually a schoolboy.
What's your name?
Alan.
Nice to meet you, Alan. All right, we got a shy one there, so. Okay, ready? So you've watched all of our videos?
Yeah.
Oh my god, you've got a lot of time on your hands.
Because I love your videos.
Subscribe. Do you think that's fashion? Why has he got that on his back? The hunchback of Hong Kong. Oh no, that guy in yellow. He's like a walking road sign. Oh, he's gone. Speed of light.
Still not entirely convinced that a defocus control, I took some more test shots.
So So let's try with the front blurry bits. Normal, let's refocus. And then rear.
If you have a closer peek, you'll notice that on the R setting, the bokeh is smoother than Barbie's backside. Better than normal mode. And on the F mode, you'll notice that the background blur is so bad it makes me want to smear jelly into my eyes.
Well, the thing is, because it's so subtle, it's quite an acquired taste. And that's probably why you don't see more of these lenses around. See, I prefer your gobsmackingly obvious effects. So I don't see the point of twiddling around this just to get such a minimal effect. I prefer a lens that just does it out of the box. But of course, the perverse thing is that it does. This is actually a very good lens, a standard. That is one big bastard of an umbrella. Selfish bastard, give me some of that.
Oh, I wish I blurred all of the photo. One of her collars match her cuffs.
That was just like some witch, the Witch of Mong Kok. Chinese Harry Potter film.
Sharp, and the out of focus bits are really quite pleasant, even without fiddling with that control your defocus wheel. Despite thinking that it's not really all that necessary to have that ring, and it might confuse a lot of people, especially those who think that you are going to become some bokeh guru with this lens. I would recommend a lens for anyone into portraits. Just don't expect too much out of that DC ring.
Wow, this defocus control is kind of weird. It makes your lip look funny, Locke.